Oh, what's going on, guys? This is MJ from Dynamic Render Labs.
And this is No Nonsense MJ, letting you know this course is 75 minutes and I have a shorter version for you in the description.
Welcome to D5 Reality, where we are going over how we can camera track and match our videos from D5 Render to drone footages. The entire course is free. But if you found it useful, I would appreciate any support. In this video, I introduce the course and go over some requirements. If you learn anything new, please give it a thumbs up, comment, and subscribe. First, I want you to know all the materials I use are available as practice files, which you can check the link in the description to obtain them. It includes a D5 file, a reference max file, and 4 drone footages for you to practice. I've added multiple subtitle options for this course, all translated using advanced language models, and I double-checked them with another AI to ensure accuracy. If you don't see yours, just leave a comment and I try to add it as soon as I can. Now, let's talk about what we're gonna learn in each chapter. In the first one, we learn how to track camera using After Effects. Then we collect data and send it to 3ds Max. In chapter 2, we match our camera to our geometry and get it ready to send to D5 Render. In chapter 3, we finish our D5 Render scene and render our video for matching to the drone footage. And finally, in chapter 4 and 5, we go back to After Effects and try to match our output to source video and adjust the colors. This will sum up the main part of the course. After that, I will add a bunch of contents over time, which can go well with the subject. Besides, I want you to send me your D5 videos and drone footages, so maybe I can make some more videos about color matching, which can be the challenging part of this course.
None of us are struggling.
You can contact me via Telegram with the link in the description. For other workflows, we can try different camera tracking tools like Synthize. Also, with D5 Render's 2.9 update, Blender now can send camera data directly, making it a strong option to both camera track and also camera match. We could have gone with Synthize and Blender in main course, but less is more, you know? I decided to focus on a straightforward workflow, avoiding multiple softwares.
Simplicity itself.
Although some of you might be new to After Effects and 3ds Max, as I know a lot of D5 users like SketchUp or Rhino for modeling and don't even edit the final footage, but think of these two like big department stores. Just grab what you need without exploring every floor, so I'm sure it won't get complicated.
Hey there, is there a project you're working on?
I know more than you.
All right.
Well, not like Blender at least. That thing is so complicated for beginners. I know it gets easier when you work for it, but God,
what the f*** is going on here?
If you want to explore other methods, of course, I'll cover them later as well. It may take some time in the future. Now, for rendering, I'm obviously using D5 Render. It's easily the best, and I have the file ready for this tutorial. If you don't know D5 Render, I'm planning on releasing my free courses for D5 soon. D5 101, D5 Plus, and D5 Projects, which will help you learn D5 effectively. So subscribe and check my channel for updates. For now, if you want to learn D5 Render, the best source is D5 Render's YouTube channel. You can also check D5's license instructor listed in D5's website. In this course, I'm going to assume you have basic knowledge of handling your projects in D5 Render. Besides, even if you're making the mistake of not using D5 Render, this course is still useful for you. Just do what I do in your own rendering software, if you can. Now about the base model. It can be from anywhere you choose. For example, I've made my scene in Rhino and surrounding matters a lot. I made the train using the data from cadmapper.com, which is a simple, great way for surroundings. And I will create a tutorial for that too someday. You can also import Google Earth data. Good tutorial too.
I wish I had more time.
You can also use D5 train to make surroundings as well. Whatever you do, don't just have your building alone. It will make the matching very hard. Just take a look at this project. Now, this is just the first draft. Look at how poorly the foreground trees blend with the project. But watch what happens when we add a proper foreground. And, well, so much more. To blend your model to the drone footage, you need to make a great deal of foreground area yourself and leave background to the video for the best result. Try to make the terrain as similar as possible. It doesn't have to be exact, but close enough. I happened to make the building's model in 3ds Max, as my client had already a basic Max model for the project, but it certainly doesn't mean you need to do the modeling in Max. Interestingly, the model I use for matching the camera is the base part I made in Rhino. So we are going to Max, assuming you know nothing about Max at all. Finally, here's the part of footage I'm trying to create the camera matching. The drone footage we had wasn't very high quality. I kinda had to do a basic upscale using Topaz Video AI, so it would work better for camera drag and also for the end result. If your quality is not good, I suggest you do this as well. I've also included more footages in practice file, as I've said before, for you to try it out. Now, before we begin, I want to thank Jake Denham for his amazing tutorial on 3ds Max motion tracking, which helped me a lot to make this video. I placed the link in the description. Go and support him for his great tutorials. I also want to thank my friend Peter for believing in me and trusting me with Project Bequa, which led me to learn this technique and now sharing it with you.
This is how it begins.
And finally, I want to thank D5 team for featuring my project in their 2024 year-end collection showreel. That was actually a great honor and truly inspiring.
I'm honored.
So, let's get it started. See you in the next video.